David, 2-1 home defeat against Distillery today. I'd imagine that's a difficult one to take.
Yeah, it's more disappointing than anything. Seemingly we're going to have to break this habit of losing games 2-1. That's all we, whenever we lose, that's what we seem to do. Yeah, so it's massively disappointing.
Started the game obviously very well, got our noses in front, but maybe just didn't sort of kick on from there.
Yeah, we didn't use that early advantage and press on and do the things that actually got us in front well enough after that to go and get 3 points. And you know, the game was there to be won. Not too sure if we deserved to lose, but we certainly didn't make it too difficult for them to go away with 3 points, which is the most disappointing thing.
Second half, probably until they scored, you know, almost did an attack against defence session, but we didn't. We made a lot of clear cut chances either. Then they go up and score, and they've, you know, a lot to hold on to then.
Yes, and it happens. I mean, they'll, you know, not be forgiven for doing that. You know, I'm sure Tommy will be delighted with 3 points regardless of how it came. So, you know, as you say, we didn't create too many clear cut chances, although we did have plenty of possession, you know, deep in their half. But you know, on most days this season, we've looked as if we're going to go up the park and score goals. And today, I think we lacked a wee bit of that.
We had a lot of, you know, free kicks, good position for throw-ins and etc. We're just maybe not making enough of those at the minute.
No, and sometimes when it's thrown in there, like we did numerous times today, it can be a bit of a, you know, if the ball breaks through, it breaks through, or if you can get that little flick on and someone's there. But, you know, maybe we just didn't show enough endeavour to get into the right places and in terms of getting into the middle of goal. I mean, first half, 3 balls dropped from throw-ins and crosses that was between the penalty spot and in the middle of the six-yard box. So, you know, on another day, we're busting a gut to get in there and we're scoring goals, but today it just didn't happen for us.
Kieran Stitt had to come in after John Connolly's suspension. He probably didn't have an awful lot to do, but he did well what he had to do.
Yeah, I have no complaints there. I mean, Stitt's a, you know, a good pro and he looks after himself, and we had no qualms about putting them in today.
Moving on to next week then, good to have another home game, maybe try and get out of the system and try and get back to winning ways, although a difficult game.
Yeah, difficult. Knockbreeder have done well. I mean, they've had some good results already this season, and you know, it's going to be another big test for us, but you know, we'll take today and digest it and work on things and during the week like we always do, and hopefully we'll put a few things right come Saturday.
I think Kieran Murray's goal is his 11th. Paul Maguire's on 10. You know, 21 between the front two in the middle of November is obviously a good return.
Yeah, it is. I mean, they've both been working well. They've scored goals. And, you know, I thought Kieran was excellent today again. You know, showing good attitude and appetite to do well. And, you know, long may it continue. Maguire's obviously, you know, the talisman here. And he gets his goals and is the leader on the pitch. So, you know, I'm happy with them too. Although, you know, they've been more threatening in past weeks. And certainly wasn't their greatest day, but you know, I think if we create chances for them, they're going to score goals.
Next week at home to Knockbreeder, we've talked about it in terms of, you know, going on runs with either wins or defeats. Suppose, you know, you don't want to go on another run, you know, with defeat.
No, obviously it's you know, we have said about that in the past, and it's quick. You have to be quick to stop the defeats mounting up, and I'll be honest and say that I hoped and I thought we would have done that today, and certainly the way it started, you know, I was pretty sure it was going to be the end of what would have been a one defeat, but you know, two in a row is difficult, and you know, you wouldn't want it to go three like it did earlier in the season, and then you're looking at yourself, you know.
Obviously very early days, only straight after the match, but you know, you've the players there. If you want to change things around, at least that's one thing for you, you know.
Yeah, two defeats in a row, as I say, is difficult, but you know, there is options there to change both personnel and shape, so it's something we'll discuss in the next couple of days as a management staff, and as we always do, and then we'll make a decision based on how we see Saturday's outcome.
Okay, David, thanks for your time. Cheers.